Hello, hello, everybody. It's 5:15 a.m. Central Time on the 2nd of November, 2022. It's Wednesday here in the United States. I'm recording a second update. Got a breaking news situation for my U.S. viewers. Something to bring to your attention. Show you what's happening over here on the west coast of the United States. We just had a 6.0 earthquake, which I made a video on. You guys can go check that out over on my YouTube channel, talking about the earthquake out here next to some undersea mount volcanoes, also next to the undersea cables. But I don't want to talk about that right now. I want to show you what actually just hit down here at the New Mexico-Arizona border. A new 3 has popped off, pretty rare over here at the New Mexico-Arizona border region. USGS has it marked out of Arizona. So let's go take a quick look and show you what's there. And I sort of already know what's at the location. There's a story behind this location I think you need to know. But first, let me show you what's there before I tell you the story. This involves the professionals, something that happened to me. So several years ago, a series of earthquakes struck here, going up to 5.0 range. And they struck right next to this thing, this old volcanic butte that exists here, okay? And up on top is an antenna and a measurement station, a weather station. They have a weather station placed up on top there, okay? So 5.0 earthquake struck next to this. I zoomed in on it. It wasn't marked at the time. There was no place mark on it from the USGS or Smithsonian. But I looked at it, and we, of course, you know, you can see, obviously, it's covered in basalt on all sides, black basalt. It's an ancient butte, an ancient volcanic butte. So I made a video on it, showed everybody the old volcano there, and talked about the old volcano there, and it just was just an old butte. Other old volcanic features around the area, including an old lava flow over to the east, northeast, and northwest. Well, a person from the American Geophysical Union showed up on YouTube under the name Space Weather. And the Space Weather channel made a video accusing me of fraud and said there were no volcanoes known in the area at all, and furthermore said that I was exaggerating this with the height elevation tool on Google to make it look like a volcano. And what he did, he came into his Google here, I can show you, and I have to talk about this. You can turn this up or down. You can turn this down to zero. And when you do that, it makes the topography, 0.1 or whatever. It makes the Earth completely flat. Notice, right? You can't see anything now. So the normal default setting to see good features, and you can go compare against your own location wherever you're at, is about 1. Will give you a good representation of pretty much what it's like. Go look around your house. Again, I live on a hill. You can go compare. You can turn it set to 1. And it matters because he accused me of fraud and said there were no volcanoes there. Then guess what? Within a year of him making his video accusing me of fraud, the Smithsonian updated their place marks and uploaded this. The Geronimo Volcanic Field, San Bernardino, covers over 140 eruptive centers, mostly pyroclastic cones, just like what I just showed you, in an area of 850 square kilometers. The basaltic field in the southeast corner of Arizona was active between 3.2 and 0.3 million years ago. So a guy from the American Geophysical Union showed up denying the earthquake here was related to the volcano that was right next to it, which I already just showed you, which is right here. I don't have a name on it. As far as I can see, there are no names or place marks placed onto this small hilltop or mountain, but it probably is named. But they denied a relation. A true professional who graded papers, he said, and I didn't deny that. He worked for NASA as well. So, grading papers and denying volcanoes when it's really a volcanic field that extends all, you see it. All of these are part of the old volcanic field. And there's another one down here. Old basalt, old volcano. So our earthquake, let's get back to it. 3.0 earthquake struck in there. Why does that matter? Well, I told my viewers to watch out for odd volcanic activity and odd earthquake activity in the time surrounding when the beam is coming back from Jupiter from HARP, going from HARP to Jupiter and back, and it's coming to here, to Owens Valley, to the antenna array in eastern Owens Valley to be received, and it's also being received over here at Socorro, New Mexico, just west of Socorro, New Mexico, which is right here. The antenna array here, the very large array. It's been in many movies like Contact and so forth with the railroad that takes the big dishes around. Okay, well, look, now we do, just west over at the state line, well, down southwest of there. It's pretty far southwest, but still, weird earthquake activity or odd earthquake activity next to volcanoes that we don't normally see go, including out in the ocean. So I just have to make you aware of the volcanic field here to let you know it has started moving along this, the deformed edge of the North American craton. Look at the purple part of this diagram. Look where it goes. See? Notice anything? Obviously, it goes down through South Arizona, the purple part. And South Arizona, let me show you what's down south of here. So here's our earthquake epicenter. And the deformed edge of the craton goes right down through here. Well, all along through here, we have huge volcanic features that number in the number, well, I mean, hundreds of separate cones just on this one volcanic field at Piñacate. We go along the border, and there's more that are far more ancient. Covered in sand, not even marked by the Smithsonian. You come over to the east, and there's several more along the border going over into Texas. And I don't even know how many are throughout here. I mean, come on, we could come in and probably find some, but I don't need to get into that. We're going too far away. So over here, along the border, going up, you see they do have marked volcanoes over to the east. But once we get to the border, they, again, were in denial up to just a few years ago. So is this related to the volcano there? Yes, 100% related to the volcano there. Energy is flowing across the edge of the North American craton, which I can turn off now. And we have activity out here in the ocean next to another undersea mount and our undersea data cables. A new 3.8 to 4.0 earthquake struck in between the two. That's off the coast of California. And this goes right here into Monterey Bay. Is that right? Hold on. There it is. Yeah. Monterey Bay, just off the coast. New 4.0 earthquake, 3.8. struck around the same time, within a few hours of each other. We're starting to move over here along the coast. So 3.8 struck since the 6, and our 3 over at the volcanoes, or volcano over in Arizona. Anything else? Has anything else happened since doing my update? Oh, China got hit by a new 5.1, which you see here. USGS weighed in, 4.9. Came in at 5.1. USGS then took over 4.9. And that's on top of the other 4.9 on the other side of it. That's two 4.9s. They were all 5s, guys. These are all 5s. They can't have too many 5s showing up on the USGS feed in one day. That'll make people raise their eyebrows because we already have, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5... It would be like 8 5s in the course of a few hours. People would start to wonder what's going on, so they got to take some of those down to 4s. You know what I mean? For the normies. This one's for the kids, you know? It's for the kids. It's always for the kids. You ever notice that? Okay, enough of this ranting. Let's go ahead and shut this off and get this saved and put it out over on YouTube for my Arizona viewers and viewers in the Southwest. What does this mean? We are looking for good amount of activity to develop in the next several days. California is due for 3 earthquakes, one up at Napa Valley, 5.0 range, one at the California-Nevada border, one at Ridgecrest, which is near the California-Nevada border, but one at Ridgecrest and one in Southern California. 3 different near 5s is what we're looking for, so could be 4.9s. I mean, you know how the USGS is. 4.9s all the way across, or 5s, And then we're also looking for the panhandle of Oklahoma at Kansas to also get something in the four-ish range. So what does this mean? Energy's coming across. It's coming across right now. You can see it. It's also going in a shape of the path of the craton. One more time, going down through Texas. It's coming right across from the south, though. Something's going on down south right now, obviously, as evidenced by the new earthquake here. Anything else going on? Let's check Southern California really quick. Has the number of earthquakes suddenly increased? Let's go take a look. If we see a big flare-up in Southern California, you know it's coming right across. Let's see. 3 struck yesterday. 2.8. Anything else? A line of earthquakes here. If you see this go up through the roof, stacks of earthquakes here start to appear suddenly, like big noticeable stacks or swarms, that'll be mean an incoming amount of energy coming straight over to the east, straight across. I mean, it's already going over this far. So I would think we're going to see a flare up, and I would think that our Southern California earthquake is so close. And we're 1 day in on the forecast for 7 days. So we have a 7-day forecast out. We are 1 day in, and this has already happened. So we're also looking for the New Madrid Seismic Zone to get near 4.0 level activity or right at it. Should strike right down here, southern Missouri. And we're looking for the East Coast to get a hit over here on the far East Coast, northeast now. Georgia already got hit, by the way. So if you missed that, Georgia got hit. Check it off the list. We warned Georgia. In case you missed that, you can go see my warning from 3-4 days ago when we talked about watching down in Georgia. And this one's a weird one. That's a weird earthquake. Location-wise, weird. Long story on that. The name of the place. The names of the place. Let's just, I don't really want to go there. Back to it, guys. Deep earthquake activity. And over in the United States, old volcanoes are getting hit with new earthquakes as the spread is going across the plate. I apologize for having to speak in subdued tones, but my wife is asleep and I can't be my normal loud self like I normally would be. Also might wake up the neighbors across the lake. It's 5:30 in the morning here. Okay, let's get this saved. I said I was going to do that a few minutes ago. Do you have an earthquake plan? Look, the volcanoes are moving all the way across from out off the coast of the United States into land over to Arizona. Do you have an earthquake plan in Southern California? I know you're supposed to, but you know you're supposed to. Do you have one? Dust it off. Go check your emergency kit. Make sure you got the stuff in it. But if you're cut off without power for a few days or something, you have food and water. I'm just reminding you, okay? So, much love. I'll be around if anything else big goes down. Look out for this as a video over on YouTube in just a few minutes. Peace out.